Honderde kilogram vis, meeste van hulle kabeljou en meeste van hulle te klein om wettiglik te hou. Hierdie is treknetvangs. As jy 'n permit het, is dit nie onwettig nie. En sommige mense reken dit is 'n baie meer omgewingsbewuste manier om vis te vang in vergelyking met kommersiële vissersbote. Terwyl ander dit as deurmekaar en onoordeelkundig beskryf.
So I went down there and obviously this particular moment I hadn't seen that many cod in the net for a long, long time. Which is clearly a good thing, but also a bad thing as the sheer numbers of the smaller fish that were caught, you know. They caught almost 2 times I've heard the report again. And out of those 2 times, more than half of them or 3/4 of the fish were actually under 5 fish, which is quite sad because that's obviously the future generation of the population. From my side, I don't anything against trout netting. It's part of the heritage and the culture of the area. I understand, obviously, it's a livelihood, and as I said, I enjoy the trout netting vibe. It brings tourists to the country and to Cape Town especially. The thing that concerns me is the way the smaller fish and the undersized fish are getting treated. But I just feel now that it's getting to a critical stage where we need to do something in terms of a bit of structure for the traders, you know.
Yeah, look, I think it's an environmentally friendly exercise in places where there isn't a bycatch issue. Unfortunately, in Musenberg's Transvaal, there is a bycatch issue with a high diversity of fish and a lot of juvenile fish. They can get large hauls or hauls that appear large to a line fisherman. As a commercial fishery, they're not particularly large catches. I believe they catch about 2 tons of kabeljau. There's lots of control measures in place. It's regulated as a commercial fishery. But yeah, the trick netting in False Bay, and particularly on the northern shore, does seem to have a high bycatch component. And it is, given that a lot of our fish species are overexploited, it's a problem. And that's, you know, when they get a large haul, they can't release species like white skimrus or undersized cod efficiently, you know. In theory, you should be able to let the fish go. But when there's a lot of fish and they get squashed in the net, it's difficult for them to release them alive. And of course, they have problems with members of the public get very excited and they grab the fish they're trying to throw back in the water. So a lot of the fish ends up not being released safely. It's a very eco-friendly way of harvesting that resource. It's, you know, arguably far better, creates more employment and has far lower footprint, the carbon footprint or whatever than running a commercial line fish boat. The fishermen themselves are quite, you know, they make the effort to release fish they're not supposed to have, you know, undersized fish or species that are not on the commercial list. And they do really try and toe the line because they're terrified they're going to have their licenses removed. You know, it's their livelihood.